The tree shown here is Platanus occidentalis, the sycamore. The sycamore is quite a large tree, reaching 75 to 100 feet in cultivation. It typically has a very wide-spreading, irregularly shaped crown, as shown here. The bark of this tree is quite distinctive. If you look near the base of the trunk, you'll find it reddish-brown to gray in color and scaly. But what's really noticeable is the upper bark of the tree, where the light gray exterior bark tends to exfoliate and expose the inner bark, which is white to cream in color. The buds of Platanus occidentalis are quite large, brown, and smooth. You'll only see them in the winter. When the leaves are still on the tree, the buds are completely surrounded by the petioles so that you can't see them unless you pluck the leaf off. You can see this somewhat in this picture, even though the leaf isn't present. You'll notice that the leaf scar completely encircles the bud. The leaves of Platanus occidentalis are quite large, 4 to 9 inches wide and often wider than they are long. Now they typically have 3 or more commonly 5 lobes, and they have acuminate tips along the margin, or you might consider them large teeth. As you can tell from the leaves in this picture, the lateral lobes of the leaf tend to bend downwards and inwards so that if you were to look at this leaf, it would look slightly folded or drooping. Now these leaves do look somewhat like a maple leaf, but the leaf arrangement for Platanus occidentalis is alternate, whereas all maples are opposite. Here again you can see how the leaves have somewhat of a folded and drooping appearance, and in addition you can see the remnants of the stipules. The stipules are quite large and prominent while still attached to the plant, and they have acuminate tips or large teeth on the margin, just like the leaves. The stipules do not persist year-round, but you will find them at the beginning of the growing season. And sometimes they may make it all the way into the fall, as you can see from the stipule shown in this picture. Again, completely surrounding the base of the petiole and with those acuminate tips on the margin. Platanus occidentalis is monoecious, so there are separate male and female flowers on the same plant. Here you can see the male flowers. They are red in color, but ultimately not that showy. In the background you can see a blurry female flower, more green in color. And here are the fruits that develop from the female flower. They are globose fruits that hang down on quite long pedicels, 3 to 6 inches long, and usually you have 1 to 2 fruits per pedicel, usually just one. These fruits are a tan color. When the seeds are mature and ready to be dispersed, you'll see this globose syncarp split open and you have this tan, very fibrous material inside the fruit. Often the fruits of Platanus occidentalis will fall to the ground first before they split open in this way. And with that, we conclude our discussion of the sycamore, Platanus occidentalis.